Which brings us to number four, the Men in Black International. Now, I've been really excited to see Men in Black International for, I don't know, a month.
We should go see it.
We should. I've been excited to see it, but it has been getting, it's its second week.
It's not getting good.
It's no one is backing me up on my want to see this. Its culture score is a 73 from Rotten Tomatoes, a 40 from Metacritic, and a 56 from IMDb. Cinema score giving it a B, which is surprising. Critics gave it a 44.9 and a 38, making the culture and critic scores 64 and 41, respectively. But then it breaks into the cash. It had a budget of $110 million. Overall, it's $52 million, with international overall of $129. Now, breaking that down a little bit more, it made $10 million this weekend, down 64% over the weekend, down 64%, 4,200 screens, $2,500 average, which is just gosh low. It's made $182 million total gross with a $72 million total net, giving it a cash score of 96. I mean, it's netted $72 million in 2 weeks. I don't know why that feels low to me, because it is.
Feels very low for only $100 million. I mean, with Thor, I mean, it's got Chris Hemsworth in it.
Yeah, I mean, and for the record, I think we had an oversaturation thing here. So they're like, they set up the perfect reboot, the perfect expansion of the universe.
Mm-hmm.
And then they set up this wonder twin couple between Thor and Valkyrie. And then they tried to capitalize on
stacked
the deck so much that everyone was like, I don't want to play that card game. Like, had it been...
There was no risk.
Like, had it been Chris Hemsworth and literally anyone else.
Or her and then anybody else.
She is not a star.
No, but she's that, like...
All right, so had it been a star and her, or Chris Hemsworth and anyone else, I think that it would have had better success. But from what I understand, it is a lather, rinse, repeat script. They were just being so safe that no one was like interested in the game.
Yeah, Ace of Insurance Magazine, he saw Men in Black last week. Meh. It also had Liam Neeson.
I knew that.
Yep. I like Liam Neeson.
I do too.
It'd be cool if Liam Neeson was the Chris Hemsworth character. Like, that's what I kinda liked about the original Men in Black. Like, Kay. Yeah, Kay, he was an older gentleman. I mean, like, He just seemed kind of dumb with it.
Yeah.
Whereas Chris Hemsworth is still very much, like, about it.
Yeah. No, absolutely.
Agree, super safe. Yeah, Marcus saying it was just super
safe. They're so safe. The thing is that, like, I understand the need or the desire to be safe, but you can't. That's not where any investment banker will tell you. The higher risk, the higher the reward. They're like, oh no, we're gonna be so safe. That's just not how it just works. It just doesn't work. It does not work.
That's why no adults want to go on the kiddie rides. I mean,
yeah.
If it's so safe, you're
not ever gonna fall out of a roller coaster. I mean, the people that do. Like, you're never gonna fall out of a roller coaster, but it's that perception that you might that is exciting. And like, you know, you take me to Wonder World and you sit me on the little dragon that goes, like, you know what?
No. It's too safe.
It's too safe.
So, culture score 64, critic score 41, cash score 96. I mean, but total, so this gives it an 8.